Hey, I'm Flavius, a technical marketing engineer here at Spacelift. In this video, I will give you a high-level overview of Spacelift, its main concepts, and how it helps your DevOps teams. Stacks are our building blocks. They represent an infrastructure automation workflow that combines your code, the tool you're using, and the environment you connect to. You can create stacks for multiple infrastructure tools, such as Terraform, OpenTofu, Ansible, Kubernetes, and others. I'm now going to create a stack. My code is in GitHub, and now I'll select my repository. I'll use Terraform to create EC2 instances. If you're using a different tool, this is the place you select it. I know that my code is using AWS, so I will use dynamic credentials to connect to it. This is the place in which you can select your cloud integration. In the summary, you can check all the details about your stack. After you are done, you can confirm. Now, my stack is created. Implementing control mechanisms can be hard, but with Spacelift that's not the case, as we are leveraging policy as code based on OPA. I have already attached a planning policy that restricts my EC2 instances to have a T3.micro type, and in my code they are T2.micro. This should deny my run. Let's trigger and see what happens. I've ran my workflow and it got denied as expected. In the meantime, I have changed the policy to restrict EC2 instances sizes to T2.micro, and now the plan policy has evaluated to allow, but I've also added an approval policy to require extra approvals for my run, so now I will approve it and we will see this in action. The run has finished successfully, and because I have a notification policy embedded, we can see that we get notified in our Spacelift inbox. This could have been easily routed to Slack or MS Teams. Having shift left mechanisms into play is great, but you need to take observability measures as well. Our resources view shows you all the resources that have been deployed with your Spacelift account. You can group them in many ways, based on the parent, based on the provider, the stack, and also the type, and you can also build whatever filters you want. By clicking on a resource, you can get relevant information about it and what is also the resource health. This is very helpful, but let's face it, you cannot stay 24/7 on this page and monitor your resources. That's where drift detection comes into play. With it, you can detect every change done to your resources without having to look at the resources view every time. Here we have a drifted resource. Spacelift also gives you the option to remediate drift as part of the drift detection feature, and as you can see, as soon as the drift is detected, a run starts in response to the detected drift. This makes your VCS the only source of truth, as it should always be in GitOps. These four features that we talked about make it so much easier to provision, configure, and manage your infrastructure pipelines. But we can make it even easier. I will now walk you through two killer features that Spacelift offers. In infrastructure, it is a best practice to keep your automations as small as possible, to keep the blast radius at a minimum. In this way, you are able to quickly identify any issues that arise with it. Spacelift lets you create dependencies on how many nested levels you want between the same or different tools, and you can even share outputs between them. In this example, I have a parent Terraform stack and two child stacks, one for Ansible and one for Kubernetes. In the first case, here I'm sending my EC2 instances as an output to Ansible to build the inventory, and in this case I'm sending my EKS login command for the Kubernetes stack to be able to log in to Kubernetes. What happens in this case is whenever the parent stack finishes a run, the child stacks will be triggered. Now there is another question worth answering. How do you take everything you put in place and open it to the rest of the team? That's where blueprints come in. So blueprints are self-service templates that create stacks, and you can select the VCS, the tool you're using, attach cloud integrations, policies, context, and even create schedules. These templates are declared using YAML. The result in the end is a form that can be filled in by anybody, and in this way your developer velocity is increased. For this example, this blueprint creates EC2 instances and you can add a name to your stack, you can select the name of the space where the stack should be, you can trigger a run upon creation, you can select how many instances you want to create, you can select their shapes, and you can even select their operating system. As soon as I click on Create Stack, these instances will be deployed. This is Spacelift in a nutshell, your one-stop shop for provisioning, configuring, and governing your infrastructure workflows.